아니요, 이 하이브리드 레이비 레스펀스이 맥시멈 파워 트랜스퍼 디그램. So mostly when you connect the load with the voltage source, so one question is coming to your mind is that when the power will be maximum, then what should be the load through which the power is power transfer from the source is maximum or at the peak level. So let's take an example, and let's we have voltage source and we represent that voltage source like V, and also we have a resistance and we represent that resistance by RP, and we have output resistance and we represent that by R now. So this is our output voltage. Now let's find the current and let's apply the KVL, and when you apply the KVL, so this is rise, so this is transformation we are collaborating. So our VT will be equal to, let's this is I, so I RT plus I R now. So I will be equal to VT divided by RT plus R now. Now let's come toward the power, and the power dissipated in R now will be equal to V naught represent the power of the output I square R now, as the I value is equal to VT by summation of all the resistance. So putting this I value in this, so V naught will be equal to VT square divided by RT plus R naught whole square R naught. So now as we know that for in mathematics, finding the maximum value or peak value, so let's see here this graph. So this is our y axis and this is x axis. So as the peak or maximum value of y is at this point, this is the such value of x at which the y value is maximum or peak. So how we find this maximum point? So for that we take a new derivative, and that will be equal to dy by dx, and as this derivative is equal to tangent theta, because tangent is equal to y perpendicular divided by base now, and also it's equal to sine theta divided by cos theta, and at maximum point we have horizontal axis and y axis is 0, or y is 0 and x axis is some value. So that's why the sine or y will be equal to 0 and it contains some value. Let's represent that number by n. So we can say that at maximum point the derivative of y with respect to x axis is 0. So we use this equation for maximum value. So now taking the derivative of independent with the dependent. So we have V naught which is dependent and R naught which is independent. So here we have R naught. So taking the derivative of V naught with respect to R naught, so we have d by d r naught v I by r t plus r naught whole square r naught. So simplify this. So when you simplify that equation, so you get d by d r naught v I square r t plus R naught whole minus 2 or no. So now apply the multiplication, apply the product rules. So we get this value Vi square Rt plus R naught minus 2 plus Vi square R naught minus 2 Rt plus R naught over minus 3. So further simplify it, so you get I square Rt plus R naught minus 2 minus 2 V I square R naught Rt plus R naught minus 3. So when you simplify this equation further, so from here you get Rt plus R naught is equal to 2 R naught. So this equation say that whenever your Rt become equal to your R naught, so you get 2 R naught, or your this equation is satisfied. So that's why whenever here you put V0, because for maximum power transfer we get the derivative in the 0. So that's why the statement of maximum power transfer theorem is for that for any resistor network and a resistor load, the maximum power will be transferred to the load when the load is equal to the total equivalent resistance of the network. So here this resistance is our total equivalent resistance of the network, and this is our load resistance. So whenever these two resistances become equal, so the power will be transferred to the load, will be maximum. And remember, one most important point is that the maximum power that can be drawn by the load can never exceed the 50% of the power delivered by the source. This is equal to 3 ohm and Vt, which is equal to 12. So when you solve it and find the current, so you get 2 ampere. Let's find the power dissipated in the load. So that will be equal to V naught to I R naught. So when you solve it, let's take the Rt is equal to R naught. So your P naught will be equal to 6 watt. Now let's see that how much power is delivered to the load by this source, to the full load. So when we solve it, so here we measure all the resistance. So that's will be equal to 2 plus 3. So that's will be equal to 12, which is 50. So here the 50% of 12 is delivered to the load R naught, which is 6. So that's why I verify that statement, that important points. And also, if you have a battery, like if you have this battery, and this battery also have some internal resistance, and that is represented by small R, and here you get the voltage is less than this battery EMF. Let's draw the electrical diagram of this battery, and that is this one. So this whole region represents the as your battery, and this is our terminal voltage. So that's why this terminal voltage is less than this EMF due to the battery internal resistance, and that is represented by this one R. So whenever your load, which is this one, and we represent that load resistance by capital R naught, whenever you want to transfer the maximum power, so you must keep your load resistance equal to your internal battery resistance. So in this way you will transfer power, you will transfer the power up to the peak value. So this is all about the maximum power transfer theorem. Thanks for watching.